Retinal scan complete.
It's good to hear she's still in your corner.
Spying on my conversations again?
Hey, I'm looking out for you. There have been whispers that the board was going to take action against you. If you lose the company, Batman will take a massive hit too. I know the cave is well equipped, but all of this is owned and paid for by the company.
It doesn't matter what the board does. We'll be fine. I'm not going to let anything get in the way of what we're doing down here.
Try saying that when you can't access this wing anymore.
True. Right now, finding out how the children of Arkham are spying on the police is more important. What have you got?
What you got?
It's Wayne Tech, Bruce. As you know, Wayne Enterprises is a telecommunications giant. If someone were to, say, build a backdoor into that tech...
You're telling me the children of Arkham hacked into the system?
So that's the thing. Do you want the good news or the bad news?
Both.
You're not gonna like it.
Give me the bad news first.
No shortage of bad news lately. Might as well just pile more on.
Then the good news
well,
after. Mix things
better. See this back door they're using? I built it.
What?
You? What are you talking about?
When your mission as Batman started, you needed a way to monitor the city. Well, this is how. I piggybacked Batman's surveillance onto Wayne Enterprises' signal.
If the children of Arkham have access to the same system, does that mean they know my identity?
It looks like they've only accessed the GCPD so far. Not a lot of activity otherwise.
They might figure
it
out.
Alfred warned Gordon. The GCPD needs to get rid of their Wayne Tech devices.
Smart move.
Bruce says, Alfred, I've got news. What is it? Did Lucius find something? Tell Gordon to break his comm. Call Gordon. Tell him to break all their comms. All of them? Anything Wayne Tech. The children of Arkham are using it to listen in. Right away, sir.
I've encrypted our access. I can fortify it, but it's going to take longer to force them out of the system. The question remains, how did the children of Arkham find out about the back door in the first place? They shouldn't have been able to find it. Not unless they knew what they were looking for. Whoever broke in certainly knew how to cover their tracks.
A mole.
We have a mole. There's no way they could have gained access without someone on the inside.
Only a handful of people at the highest level could possibly find out about the back door. I'm gonna keep working on this Children of Arkham business. See if there's a way to shut down their access entirely.
We'd better lock this stuff down, just in case.
Check for upgrades and then hide your bat tech. It couldn't be, another personality of Dent already. Could it? Maybe he's already off his rocker. And the good Dent knows nothing about it. Hit the lights. All the stuff's on the table here. There's nothing else. Oh, the whiteboard. Let's look at the whiteboard.
Looks like another invaluable piece of Lucius Fox technology.
Flag's chipset architecture. Photograph.
Tiffany's really taking after you. And Luke, stubborn as always.
I think of what Gotham has become. And I think of them. They give me all the reason I need to work with Batman. He's the only one that will truly protect them.
And he will, Lucius. Always.
Got the table.
I always wonder why he had a table that could hide itself. Guess it's coming in pretty handy now.
Trust me. It was much more paranoia than precaution.
It's a fine line, I guess. Look at the drone.
Ooh, what's this?
It's a drone.
Something I'm still working on. Some new armament to assist you in the field. There's only so much you can do on your own. but it's not really ready yet.
It's not a gun on there, is it? Sticky bomb?
A new sticky bomb I developed. The signal is activated on the underside. Attach it wherever you need, then detonate it remotely with your gauntlet. Boom.
Nice.
Be careful. Those things pack a serious punch.
They better. Well, I call this a mask, but I guess because it has a top and a back, it's a cowl.
Thermal vision. You've been busy, haven't you, Lucius?
Bat grapple.
Not sure I'll ever get the first one back from Selena.
Wonder if that's the only thing she stole.
I wouldn't doubt it. Batarang! Hide gadgets. Watch the news.
Newly elected Mayor Harvey Dent gave a rousing speech late last night, refuting claims that the children of Arkham were gaining control in Gotham. Despite his run-in with the masked group on the way to the event, people are still hopeful that Mayor Dent can pull through on his campaign promises.
Who are the children of Arkham really fighting for? Who is Batman really protecting? Because it's not us. It's time that we, not masked vigilantes and violent fringe groups, fought for ourselves. I will fight every day for Gotham. And I ask that you join me. We are proud citizens of Gotham. And this is our city.
Next up, we speak to Commissioner Grogan regarding increased security measures citywide.
Grogan? It's Gordon. Well, is it Gordon, not Commissioner yet? It's Grogan. We're supposed to hide our stuff. Cool.
Looks like Regina's headed to my office. I should go.
And before you do...
I didn't get to talk to him first.
Here.
Dish.
Get that back to the Bat Computer.
The
It'll
Bat
install
computer.
The added security measures. You'll also have all the info I found on the Children of Arkham's activity within the system.
Thanks, Lucius.
I've always got your back, Batman.
Your Bat Bat
now
Bat
Batman. Here. Regina doesn't like to be kept waiting.
She can chill. Okay, let me reset this thing again. Close a secret door.
Mr. Wayne. Ruth. Open up.
And say the magic word. Open Saskatchewan.
I thought maybe you left.
Yeah, right.
Well... The board has voted.
And have they sent the chairwoman to wield the axe?
You're being asked to step down from your position as CEO.
What?
Effective immediately. At least until this whole mess gets cleaned up.
Absolutely not.
We're out of options, I'm afraid.
I won't do it.
Bruce.
This is my company. My name.
And that name is exactly why we're in this situation. This isn't a request, Bruce.
Said
I asked to slow all this down, but...
Asked to step down.
The press release is going out as we speak. There will be a public event in the morning where you will formally announce your resignation.
And if I don't show up?
I'm sorry, Bruce. I tried to fight for you. The board believes this is the only logical course of action. I see where they're coming from.
Thanks for trying.
I really appreciate you trying, Regina. Thanks.
Don't mention it. Our stock is tanking. The board is losing confidence. Wayne Enterprises needs a new face.
How about
they
Batman?
Already had a candidate in mind. I thought it was... I was outvoted. Remember, he'd only be interim CEO. Just until this mess gets cleared up.
Who?
And who would that be?
Dent? Did he explain to people about the face?
Oswald Cobblepot.
You've gotta be kidding me.
Oh boy, good to see you again.
Refused.
What a chilly greeting.
As you know, Oswald's parents were, well, victims of your father's actions. This company was built on the land he stole from the Cobblepot family.
Well, the board thought having me step in would be a good PR move.
What better way to show Gotham that Wayne Enterprises is committed to righting the wrongs of the past?
Happy to help any way I can. People aren't much behind the Wayne name now. And considering that your parents...
What about your revolution?
Cobblepot sits easier on the tongue.
I hear you've been keeping yourself pretty busy, Oswald. You sure you can handle this?
Yeah, I didn't mention revolution.
Revolution that you had to handle?
I'm a brilliant multitasker.
The board has complete confidence in Mr. Cobblepot. As his resume goes into great detail, his endeavors in England have been quite successful. Besides,
you don't know about all his
the company
endeavors.
Basically runs itself at this point. The CEO is mostly a figurehead. Don't make this harder than it has to be.
I probably shouldn't do this. He's a criminal.
I refuse to hand my company over to a criminal.
Don't do this, Bruce.
Oh, don't worry now. I'm going to take good care of this place.
I'll bust
you
up.
We need you to leave the building immediately. We'll have your personal effects sent to you.
This is a fine. How do you do?
Congratulations, Bruce. I couldn't be prouder of you. Alfred. Oh, how sweet. Graduation present.
Give me that.
Surely we could let him take this along.
I hope he doesn't find out the secret thing.
Oh,
hey!
Bruce. Clumsy. No
punch.
Wonder you're not being trusted with nice things anymore.
I'll call someone in to clean that up.
Yeah, punch.
It'll only take a minute. Bruce!
Nice.
I need security in here right
I
now.
I probably shouldn't have done
no,
that.
What was that
This is
for?
A disaster.
You've lost your bloody mind.
Dropping
Bruce,
my freaking heirloom.
Stop this. Oh, for heaven's sake, calm down. What's gotten into you? This isn't helping.
Shut up, lady. Whoop.
Get him out of my office.
Let's
I'm
go.
I'm so sorry, Mr. Cobblepot. I'll go fetch the medic.
That's very kind of you, Regina. Thank you.
Slimy little weasel. Oh, jeez.
Bruce, they're out of their minds. They can't do this to you.
Yeah.
This isn't over yet, Lucius.
The entrance.
I took care of it.
We can't let anyone find out what's down there, Bruce.
Oh, we can't get in without the horse knight.
There are ways they can
knight
get
chest
in.
Piece.
You know that.
It's secure.
It's all safe. Don't worry.
For how long?
Lucius,
I don't know.
I need to know there's someone I can trust on the inside.
I'm here for you, Bruce. I've always been here for you, not them.
We know we can trust them. What are you saying that
for? I'll have to stop working on our side project. That means no new tech, no repairs if you need them. I could keep an eye on things for you. Let you know what they're up to. Feed you what information I can. But
yeah, be my ally there.
I can't risk Cobblepot finding out what I'm up to.
No, Lucius, I need you to stay here.
But...
You're the only ally I have in this building. It's important. I need you to be my eyes and ears.
All right, I can do that.
Keep Oswald out of R&D. And let me know if anything comes up.
Keep that drive safe.
Sounds like a good idea. Oh, my purple stuff.
Bruce Wayne will speak on the issue at a press event tomorrow morning, where we'll learn more about his decision to step down.
Now I'm gonna sleep in.
In a moment.
I'm not doing
it. I still can't believe it.
Which part?
I wish life were easier for you, Bruce.
Well, you have my tea and crumpets there. Can't be that bad. Another. Nice to have you.
I'm glad I have you, Al.
Buddy.
Always.
Aw.
Lieutenant Gordon. He said there's nothing to be done about Oswald Cobblepot. All his records are spotless. He needs proof to dig further.
Penguin's slippery, all right. With the Children of Arkham accessing Wayne Tech, I have to figure out what their next move is.
Alright. Check Lucius's drive. Access the Codex, Gotham feed. Check the Codex. All of a sudden his head went bloop. Alright. Okay, so these ones with question marks, or exclamation marks, sorry, are new. Just check out these, because we've seen the others. Penguin. Crimes. Arms dealing, illegal boxing matches, and receiving stolen property. I introduced Penguin to the Bat. Not surprised he would be a fan, as strange as that might seem. The Penguin is obviously working on some bigger plan, but Selina is the one in immediate danger. After what happened with Falcone, I don't intend to underestimate him again. I didn't even recognize my own friend Oswald anymore. All I see is the Penguin. When he reappeared in Gotham City, I was a fool to dismiss his ramblings about revenge and revolution. He is central to whatever conspiracy is unfolding in Gotham. The pieces are all there. The psychoactive chemicals, Falcone's murder, and the investigation of my father and Mayor Hill. I have to figure out what the Penguin is up to before he makes good on the rest of his promises. Montoya. Sergeant, Gotham City Police Department. Jim Gordon says she's a good cop. True blue were his words. Yet someone got her to murder Carmine Falcone in cold blood, turning her into a pawn to further a mysterious revolution. Unless I figure out who's really behind the killing and why she'll unfairly take the fall. Lucius Fox, head of Wayne Enterprises Research and Development Division. He's the only person I trust to develop all of the tech for Batman while maintaining a low profile. He built the backdoor into Wayne Enterprises' system for the benefit of Batman. But now the Children of Arkham have found that door and can exploit the same information. Luckily, Lucius increased the security measures on Batman's signal, so they won't be able to get into our system. For now, anyway. I'm gonna save this for last, just because I feel like it. I got stuff over here, too. Children of Arkham. They officially reveal themselves at the debate, but the Children of Arkham have been lurking around for a while. The heist at City Hall, the stolen chemicals at the docks, Falcone's murder, they all link back to the Children of Arkham. Penguin's one of them, but I'm more worried about their mysterious leader. Speaking of whom? Children of Arkham leader. The mass leader of the Children of Arkham. There's no indication as to who it might be, but it looks like he's the one pulling the strings in the whole operation. Even Penguin was taking orders from him. I just wish I knew what they're really after so I can stop it. Yeah, I wonder who that could be. Some kind of version of Joker? Or Bane? I don't know. He's got the, you know, altered voice like Bane does. Crime Alley, Park Row, Gotham City. The spot where my parents were assassinated. The alley across from the Monarch Theater is the place my childhood ended and the rest of my life began. Violently. Despite the fact that I installed a plaque there to honor them, I've made sure the alley... Why do I keep saying alley? The alley has looked the same as the night my parents were shot. Why should I attempt to erase what can never be forgotten? Instead, I need to understand why they died. And finally... Wayne Tech. Wayne Enterprises is a corporate conglomerate, and Wayne Tech handles our telecommunications branch through phones, computers, and other technological devices. Lucius built a backdoor into the Wayne Tech system for Batman so I could monitor the city and keep Gotham safe. But the Children of Arkham have found a way to access the same information, and while they can't spy on Batman, it won't stop them from spying on the rest of the city. Alright. That's all the new ones. Gotham Feed. Too Much for Batman? By James Hagopian. Whoop. It wouldn't stop. A GCPD task force was attacked by members of the Children of Arkham last night after attempting to apprehend the group during a drug deal at the Wayne Memorial Hospital construction site. One officer is in the hospital in critical condition, another has been reported missing. An anonymous source places Batman on the scene, but only after the GCPD were ambushed by the Children of Arkham. Sergeant Renee Montoya was also on the scene, although it was rumored she had recently been suspended from the GCPD. Allowing the Children of Arkham to escape with an unknown number of drugs is a massive hit against Gotham City and Batman. If the deal could not have been thwarted, how does Batman expect to deal with the Children of Arkham as a whole? Batman and Catwoman, Friends or Foes, by Oscar Pinion. He has an opinion. Get it? Opinion. I was just looking to see if that was a funny name as well. As details following the mayoral debate continue to be released, one struck me as particularly odd. Batman was on the scene, but so was the mysterious Catwoman, the thief who broke into City Hall recently. The two were caught fighting atop City Hall after the break-in, and yet, at the debate, they appeared to be working together. Are they partners or enemies? Batman has been a beacon of hope to the citizens of Gotham, but this recent development seems to show that the Bat may be more of a hypocrite than we have been led to believe. Eh. Let's see about that. Batman even went so far as to save his feline companion after she was cornered by members of the Children of Arkham. It must be good to be friends with the Bat. Perhaps Mayor Harvey Dent should have donated to Batman to ensure his own safety. Yeah, I can't be everywhere at once, that's what I said. Mysterious Compound Found in Gotham Warehouse by Julia Martins. This is from the first episode. GCPD's forensic department has released their findings from the warehouse in Gotham's East End, where they found several freight containers ransacked, residue from a massive explosion, and several bodies of assailants, as well as members of the GCPD. Forensic scientists' leading theory is that the chemical found at the warehouse 133 was a similar drug to the one used at the mayoral debate. With the mayoral debate still under investigation, it is still too early to make any connection to the two crime scenes, a spokesperson for the department stated. The origins of the compound remain unknown, but recent shipping logs from the warehouse indicate the chemical may have been developed by Ace Chemicals in Gotham City. Frustration and Relief Over Mayoral Election by Wilson Yee. After Harvey Dent was elected to the mayoral seat of Gotham following his now unopposed bid for the position, many citizens of Gotham expressed their support as well as their concerns over the new mayor. Yeah, I wonder if he mentioned the half mask on his face. I mean, it looks really strange. I hope he just didn't come on and, like, expect people not to notice it or something. A Gothamite cited their relief at Dent's nomination. Imagine if Gotham had stayed under the thumb of Hill. He was a cancer on the city. I'm glad he's gone. Harvey Dent can actually raise our city up to where it belongs. It's not fair, a former Hamilton Hill supporter replied. What kind of a city are we if we're willing to elect whoever happens to have a pulse? There wasn't even a second option. We don't know how many people actually voted for Dent. Not that it mattered in the end. Dent's poll numbers were well over 70% following the mayoral debate. Demand for Bruce Wayne's resignation by Thomas Ador. Following the recent allegations mounted against the late Thomas Wayne concerning his connections to mob boss Carmine Falcone and former Mayor Hill, citizens of Gotham have begun to ask for Bruce Wayne to resign as the CEO of Wayne Enterprises. While the deeds of Bruce Wayne have always been in support of Gotham and her people, the recent evidence against his father has only raised suspicions against Mr. Wayne and his company as a whole. No statement has been released from Mr. Wayne or his representatives, but unless action is taken against him, the city of Gotham will continue their demands for new blood within Wayne Enterprises. Alright, let's check Lucius's drive. So let me reset here.
Bring up a searchable network of all possible electronic traffic related to Wayne Enterprises. If the Children of Arkham are in our system, all of this is potentially accessible.
All of this?
Lucius was very thorough.
All of this?
It means that they could have eyes and ears into almost everything in Gotham. Just like Batman. They had access to the GCPD, we know that. The real question is, what else they'd be interested in? Filter for possible targets based on known Children of Arkham activity.
Frame rate hits. I got City Hall. View the records from Arkham Asylum.
Patients committed to Arkham going back 20 years.
A rather extensive list.
With my father's signature as the transferring doctor. Security footage.
These date back decades.
Alfred, the video at the debate. It's real. This is how they found their evidence. Something Hill did gave them access. At least now I know the truth.
Alright, we got City Hall, Courthouse, and GCPD. Let us listen to City Hall.
Yes, I know it takes time.
The understatement of the century, considering I've got at least one of my guys in the ER.
Yes, just please let me know when it happens. The Children of Arkham aren't going to wait on us.
I suppose I can understand the truth of that.
Harvey has no idea. Huh. It's impossible to tell if the Children of Arkham have access to this, but if they do, any action he takes against them, they'll see coming.
Yeah.
Are you done here, sir?
No. Give me a minute.
Not yet.
I have to look at all the other stuff. View the records.
City Hall, record of Gotham mayors.
Hill had been in office for so long, it's hard to remember a time when he wasn't mayor.
Look at this. Theodore Cobblepot. Deceased 2 weeks before the election.
Whoops. Alright, what about the records at the courthouse?
Gotham Courthouse. All public records pass through this place. Now look at this. Oswald's public record. None of this is right.
His whole criminal history doesn't exist as far as the rest of the world is concerned.
This must be what the board saw.
Not a blemish in sight.
Yep. Okay, we've got rid of that. And then we got Gotham City Police here.
I wonder if they've cleared out all the Wayne tech.
This is ridiculous, Gordon. Do you know how much all this equipment costs? We don't have the budget to replace it all.
It's a risk we've got to take, Commissioner.
If the children of Arkham can hack into our systems, we're completely ineffective.
And you think going into situations completely blind is any better?
Considering the alternative, yes.
Tell them.
Sounds like they've got the situation under control.
Nah. Good. One less problem to deal with.
Okay. So the only thing left to do is warn Harvey.
I've seen enough. I have to go warn Harvey. Keep an eye on this, Alfred, and have Lucius look into it as well. We need to find a way to lock them out.
Very good, sir.
Excellent, sir.